You are playing video games in your room. Your mom comes and offers you a fresh serving of a soft drink. You are so busy playing games that you completely forgot about the drink. By the time you realize, the drink has already lost its fizz and become flat or sugar water. Why did that happen, you wonder? Why do you have so much of difficulty in breathing, walking, or thinking when you land in a high altitude region like Himalayas? And why is marine life found only at the bottom of the sea, but not at the surface? The answers to these questions might seem unrelated, but there is exactly one science behind all these. Hello again, welcome back to Chemisphere. My name is Chandan Biswas. Believe it or not, the answers to all these phenomena have one common link. English scientist William Henry found the answers to these in early 19th century. To help understand this concept, go down to the shops and get yourself a bottle of, let's say, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, or lemonade. Inside the bottle, you will see a space between the liquid and the cap of the bottle. This space contains gas, basically. This gas happens to be pressurized carbon dioxide. That's why you hear a pop sound or a fizzy sound whenever you open that bottle. That is basically carbon dioxide leaving the bottle. So what did William Henry discover? He discovered that whenever you increase the pressure of any gas upon a liquid, the gas tends to dissolve more and more inside the liquid. That's why these soft drinks are dissolved in so much of high pressure whenever they are packed inside that bottle. The pressurized gas is nothing but carbon dioxide, which gives them the characteristic fizzy flavor. So William Henry studied the relations between the pressure and the solubility of that gas inside that liquid. He found out that the pressure applied is proportional to the amount of gas inside that liquid. This relationship was known as Henry's law. Henry's law is one of the many gas laws which have been formulated, and that statement for Henry's law goes like this. At a constant temperature, the amount of a given gas that dissolves in a given type and volume of a liquid is directly proportional to the partial pressure of that gas in equilibrium with that liquid. The equation to keep that in mind is this: P equal to KH chi, where P is the partial pressure of the gas, whichever you are exerting on the top of the liquid. KH is the Henry's constant. This KH value is defined differently for different gases, and it is different for different temperatures as well. While the chi value denotes the mole fraction of that gas inside the liquid. The constant is actually very important because this tells us how much soluble any gas is. For example, if a gas has a high KH value, it means that it is very less soluble. And it also means that if any gas has low KH value, it will be more soluble inside the particular liquid. We have also mentioned this term called partial pressure. Now, what exactly is this partial pressure? Partial pressure is the pressure which is applied when you have a mixture of gas inside any container or something. Let's say we have two gases, gases A and B. They are both mixed in a container of volume V. So the partial pressure of gas A will be written as NaRT upon V, and partial pressure of gas B will be written as NbRT upon V. So when you add all the partial pressures inside a container, you get basically the total pressure inside that container. As simple as that. So total pressure will be written as Pa plus Pb. So in short, we can say that we are talking about the fractional pressure of the total pressure inside a container. So the formula is very simple, but is Henry's law applicable all the time? The answer is no. The first limitation of Henry's law is that it does not work at high pressures. It also does not work when the gases are reacting with each other. And the third limitation of this is it only works when the reaction is at equilibrium, or you can say if it is a saturated solution already. Only then it will work. This graph shows the relation between the pressure and the mole fraction, or you can say the solubility of any gas. And you can see that it is increasing with increase in pressure. So how does this law answer all the three questions which we started in the beginning of the video? When we talked about aquatic life, as we already saw that if the gas has very high KH value, the gas becomes very, very less soluble. And that's exactly what happens when you dissolve oxygen inside water. So when you see that aquatic life is only supported at the bottom of the sea, where the pressure is very high and the oxygen gets dissolved even more. So you have more dissolved oxygen for them to respire. The other fact was also true, which means that when you go to high altitude regions, you feel a lot of tiredness, right? And also you feel fatigue and you are unable to think clearly. Why does that happen? Because the pressure is low over there. And due to low pressure, the oxygen dissolving in your blood is also less. Your brain does not get enough oxygen, and that's why its working capacity is hampered. And you are not able to think clearly. And talking about the soft drink problem, the pressurized container is already gone, right? You are keeping it at atmospheric pressure, which is already very low pressure than what was there inside the bottle. So all the CO2 starts escaping as bubbles, and you might see them in the glass as well. That's why it loses all the fizz it had when it was in bottle. Crazy, right? It's fun to see how nature works differently in different regions. Henry's law is truly mind-blowing in every sense. And it brilliantly relates chemistry to our day-to-day life experiences. And that also marks the end of this lecture. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this video. If you did, do not forget to give a thumbs up on this video and do not forget to subscribe to Chemisphere channel as well. I post regular content like this, and do leave a comment what you think about this video and what topic would you like to see the next video on. I'll see you in the next video then. Bye-bye.